So we are going to learn 7th standard science lesson number 3. Name of the lesson is Properties of Natural Resources. Okay. Now properties of air. Air is all around us. Okay. We cannot see it. Can we see air? We can't see it. But we can feel it. So yet we feel the presence of air. When we inhale, air is taken in through the nose. When we inhale, air is taken in through the nose. If we blow on our hand through our lips, we can feel the air. Okay, try this. So now they have given a short experiment to do. Okay, first I'll read first point. Take a stick from a broom. You have to take a stick from a broom or a paper or a plastic straw. Here you can see here, okay? Tie a thread at its center. You have to tie the thread at its center and you have to hang it. You have to hang it, okay? So that it remains horizontal. The straw must be horizontal. Now tie two rubber balloons. You have to tie two rubber balloons of the same size. Same size, two rubber balloons you have to tie there. Where you have to tie? At the end of the stick. Okay. Now, see to it that the stick remains horizontal. The stick must be horizontal. Now remove one balloon. You have to remove now one balloon. Inflate it and tie it again. Okay. You have to remove the air from it and you have to tie it again at its original position. Does the stick remain horizontal? Yes? No. The stick goes down on the side of the inflated balloon. Weight is not balanced. This means that air has weight. So air also has weight. Okay? Air is a mixture of gas. Air is a mixture of gases. Okay. Therefore, like all other matter, it has mass and weight. Air also has mass and weight. Okay. Now, here they are given the second experiment. Take an injection syringe without the needle, you have to take the injection. Pull its piston and observe it as you do so. Okay, you have to pull its piston. Here is a piston, you have to pull it. Okay, and you have to observe. The piston can be pulled out easily. You can pull it out easily. The piston then remains in that position even if you let it go. The piston then remains in that position even if you let it go. Now, close the inlet hole of the syringe tightly. Here you can see the inlet hole. Okay, you have to close it tightly with your thumb. Okay, and now you have to pull the piston and let it go. Okay, is the force required to pull out the piston more or less than before? Does the piston remain as it is after you let it go? Okay. The molecules of the gases in the air are in constant motion. The molecules of the gases in the air are in the constant motion. When these molecules strike a body, they create pressure on the body. They create the pressure on that body. This is the pressure of air that we call atmospheric pressure. This pressure we call as the atmospheric pressure. Okay. Now, on pulling the piston with the inlet hole of the syringe closed, more space becomes available. On pulling the piston with the inlet hole of the syringe closed, more space becomes available to the air in the syringe and it becomes rarefied. As a result, the pressure of the air in the syringe is lowered. The pressure of the air in the syringe is lowered. Comparatively, the pressure of the outside air is very high. Okay, outside air's pressure is very high. That is why when the pulled out piston is released, it is immediately pushed in. Okay, if this experiment is repeated, holding the syringe in the different positions like vertical, horizontal or inclined, the piston is found to go in into the same extent in all the cases. From this we can infer that atmospheric pressure is the same in all the directions. Atmospheric pressure is the same in all the directions. Okay, now come to page number 17. So you have to find out, what you have to find out is do Google and see that is there any atmospheric pressure on the moon. Okay, now come here to the pink box. Great scientist. In 1726, the Swedish scientist Daniel Bernoulli put forth the important principle that the pressure of air decreases when its velocity increases, while the pressure of air increases when its velocity decreases. Okay, what is the important principle? That the pressure of air decreases when its velocity increases, and while the pressure of air increases when its velocity decreases. Okay, if a body is moving through air, the air pressure decreases. Okay, if a body is moving through air, the air pressure decreases. Okay, perpendicular to the direction of the motion, and then the air is in surroundings flow rapidly from higher pressure to the lower pressure. Okay, if a body is moving through air, the air pressure decreases perpendicular to the direction of the motion, and then the air in its surroundings flow rapidly from higher pressure to the lower pressure. Okay, now you have to observe and discuss. Take some water in a plastic cup and hold a straw upright in it. You can see here is a straw, okay, in a plastic cup. So hold a small piece of another straw near the upper end. Here you can see the another straw at the upper end of the first straw. This is the first straw, this is the second straw, and perpendicular to that straw. So it is kept perpendicular. Okay, blow hard through the small piece of straw. You have to blow hard through the small piece of straw. You will see a fountain of water. Okay, so you can see the fountain of water. Why did this happen? The reason is air only. Okay, so we'll see here further. On blowing through the straw, the air at its open end is pushed away. On blowing through the straw, the air at its open end is pushed away, and hence the pressure of the air at the opening goes down. Okay, as the pressure of the air near the upper end of the erect straw becomes less, then atmospheric pressure, the water in the cup is pushed from where the pressure is higher to where it is lower, from higher to lower. Okay, that is in the upward direction. Okay, and the water comes out in the form of a fountain. You can see the fountain of water. Okay, the more forcefully you blow, the higher will be the fountain. Okay, this straw fountain works on Bernoulli's principle. Okay, you can see here the diagram they have given of effects of air pressure. Okay,
Now you have to use your brain power. What is the effect of increased temperature on the pressure of air? Okay. Come to page number 18. When there exists a difference in the air pressure at two different places, the air starts flowing from the place of higher pressure to the place of lower pressure. Okay. At such times, we feel a breeze or a wind blowing. We feel what? A breeze or a wind blowing. Thus, winds are an effect of the difference in air pressure. Thus, what? Winds are an effect of the difference in air pressure. You will learn more about this in the lesson called Winds in Geography. In geography, you will have a lesson known as winds and you will learn more about it. Okay. Now, again, one experiment they have given you to try. So, try this. Take ice cubes in a glass up to 3/4 of its height. Up to 3/4 of its height. Okay. Not half. You have to take it 3/4. Now, observe what happens. And how did the water droplets appear on the outside of the glass? When you put cold water also in a glass, you can see outside layer, okay? So, due to the ice cubes in the glass, the air surroundings the glass cooled down. As the water vapor in this air cools down, it condenses and gets transferred into water. It is this water that collects on the other surface of the glass. The level of humidity is different in different places. Similarly, the humidity levels also change from time to time during the period of a single day. So, in the afternoon, when the temperature of the air is high, the capacity of the air to hold the moisture also increases. Then compared to its full capacity to hold water, the proportion of moisture in the air is less. And we feel that the air is dry. The proportion of water vapor in the air is high. During the monsoons and in coastal areas. As a result, we feel the dampness or humidity. Okay. In summer, wet clothes dry quickly, but in the rains, they do not. Why is this so? Okay, here they have given you the question. So, here they have given you the activity also. So, read it what they have given. We come to know from the activities above that air has properties like occupying space, having a certain volume, having mass and weight. Air is a mixture of very fine particles of some gases, dust, smoke, and moisture.
Air is what? It is a mixture of very fine particles of some gases, dust, smoke, and moisture. When rays of light falls on these minute particles, the particles spread the light in all the direction. You can see this in the sun rays in the window, okay? Or near the door, you can see this. That when rays of light fall on these minute particles, the particles spread the light in all the directions. This natural phenomena is called scattering of light. This natural phenomena is called the scattering of light. Okay, now come to page number 19. So, temperature regulation. The earth receives energy from the sun. From where do the earth receive energy? It receives energy from the sun. This energy is reflected by the earth. This energy is reflected by the earth in the form of heat. This energy is reflected by the earth in the form of heat. The constituents of air surrounding the earth, such as water vapor, carbon dioxide, absorb a part of this heat and give it to the other constituents of air. The constituents of air surrounding the earth, such as water vapor, carbon dioxide, absorb a part of this heat and then give it to the other constituents of air. As a result, the earth's surface remains warm and thereby becomes suitable for the living world. Okay, earth surface remains warm, so thereby what happens, it becomes suitable for the living world on the earth. Okay, if there were no air on the earth, the average temperature of the earth's surface would have been very low. Okay, so what if there were no air on the air on the earth? The average temperature of the earth's surface would have been very low. Okay, now transmission of sound. All the sounds that we hear reach us through the surrounding air. All the sounds that we hear, it reach us through the surrounding air. The density of air also changes due to change in the temperature. All the surroundings that we hear reach us through the surrounding air. The density of air also changes due to change in its temperature. In winter, the density of the air increases. In winter, the density of the air increases. We can hear the whistle of a distant train. Okay, you might be hearing at night, especially you can hear the whistle of the distant train clearly early in the morning in winter. Okay, in winter we can hear it clearly in the morning. Okay, air is useful as a medium for the transmission of sound. Air is useful as a medium for the transmission of a sound. Okay, now what are the states in which water is found? It is found how? In the liquid states. Okay, so now what inference will you draw from the pictures alongside? Here they have given you the picture. So water occurs in liquid state under ordinary condition. Under ordinary condition, water occurs in liquid state. Water is a fluid substance. Water is a fluid substance. Water does not have its own shape. Water doesn't have its shape but has a volume. It doesn't have shape but it has a volume. It can pass through small holes or sieve
through very small gaps or cracks. Okay, it can pass through very small holes or seep through very small gaps or cracks. Okay, so here they have given you again properties of water. On pouring water in an oil clogged dish, water does not spread but forms small round drops. Why does this happen? Okay, on oil water doesn't float. Okay, it remains as it is. So here they have given you one experiment to try. So come to page number 20. Why do we see the ice float on water? So this can come as give reason or answer in sentence, one sentence like this also. Why do we see the ice float on water? Or why do ice float on water? Ice is lighter than water. Ice is lighter than water. When water freezes to form ice, it becomes lighter. When water freezes to form ice, it becomes lighter than the original liquid. Okay, it becomes lighter than the original liquid. When water freezes, that is when it transforms into the solid state, from liquid to solid state, its volume increases. Therefore, the density of ice is less than that of water. Density of light, density of ice is less than that of water. That is why the ice floats on water. This is the reason why the ice floats on water. Okay.